Hello students, in part 1 of writing skills, we did the two writing skills, that is speech writing and expansion of idea. In this video, we shall continue with the revision of the other writing skills. The first one is interview. Now the section of the interview or stage of an interview. So how do you start? You have the format for writing an interview. That is, of course, you will ask questions, but there are ways to ask questions. There is a particular flow in which you have to ask the questions. So first few questions will be like, you know, introduction. Then the next few questions will be opening questions. Then you will have the main board, that the main questions, concluding questions, and then the summing up. Okay. So when you frame interview questions, you have to identify or you have to remember these 6 points. That is, you will begin with a cordial welcome because you are going to interview a great personality. You will not interview just a normal person or just an ordinary person. Of course, if you are interviewing a particular person, then that person must have done some kind of great achievement, or that person must have had a great achievement in his life. Okay. And so you have to welcome the guest that you will be interviewing. Okay. Then your question should emerge from the immediate context, like what context that person you are interviewing in. Okay, whether the person is a dancer or a cricketer or an actor or a doctor. So what is the contribution of the person? So accordingly, you will start with your question. Also, all questions should be open-ended questions, like don't ask yes, no questions. Questions which will help them to answer. Okay, so ask those kind of questions. Then questions should be in a proper sequence and relevant to the situation. If someone is a doctor, then you cannot ask him that, okay, so how do you enjoy in your game? So there is, enjoy in your profession. So that is not a relevant question. Okay. So you have to use proper relevant questions, okay, according to the achievements of the particular individual, okay, or the field of that individual. And also the question should be in proper sequence. Okay, first do not ask a very in-depth question and then you come towards the, you know, the beginning of their career question. So don't do that. You follow proper sequence. So as I said, do not ask a yes or no questions. Okay, use questions which will help them to answer and give their life experiences through the interview. Okay. And at the end, you will say a thank you or thanksgiving note at the end of the interview. So here there's a sample interview, like Miss Mabel, your teacher has recently retired after 30 years of service to the school or college. So you have been asked to interview her for your magazine, okay, school or college magazine. So you have to prepare a list of questions. So as I said, you will begin with a welcome. So how do you begin is, welcome Miss Mabel, congratulations on your retirement and best wishes for your life ahead. Then you start, how do you feel after retiring from such a long service? Then you know, introductory question, like how did you begin your career? How do you differentiate teaching profession from other professions? What pleasant memories you have of your school, college, or what changes have you seen, like current situation, okay, in the school and students? Then how do you think use of technology in education has changed, or any advice that, and towards the end, like concluding question, like what advice you would give to young teachers and students. And finally, of course, because you've retired, what plans do you have after retirement? So once again, we thank you for being with us and giving us some precious time from your busy schedule. Okay. So that way you end your speech, the interview. Okay. The next writing skill is view counter view. Okay. Now here what happens is, there are two ways of looking, you know, at a particular topic. That is view, like what are the positive points. It's a statement about the topic. So it's called like in a debate, okay? So for the topic and against the topic you have, no, in the debate, like some one group of students, they will talk for the particular topic and the other group will talk against the topic, okay? So here also view means you're talking for the topic that is given to you, and counter view means you're talking against the topic which is given to you, okay? So in the view section, you will see all the supportive or good points in the view of the statement. And in the counter view section, you will see all the bad points or the disadvantages or the negative things about the topic which is given to you. Okay. Now, when you're writing view and counter view, there are a few things that you need to remember. In the counter view, write a paragraph that goes against the points given in the view section. So you will be given view section in the question paper. So your counter view will have points which will be against. So that is opposite, okay, to the view section points which are given to you. So do not write points in the counter view. Like, you know, don't write in points, point ways. You can explain. Okay. So you will include all relevant points, which is against the topic. You will put points forcefully. Okay. So that the person is quite, you know, convinced that why the topic should be against. Or you have to provide data and statistics to prove points. You have to give information, but you cannot, you know, just give your viewpoints over there. You can use easy language and correct sentences. Do not offend any person. Okay, if you're talking about a particular topic, then don't state somebody or somebody's name and then, you know, say something like that happened and so this and this happened. So don't offend someone through your counter view, and do not put forward any political or racial, you know, statement which might, you know, cause controversies. So see that you write the against point, but they should be in proper manner. Like here, prepare a paragraph for a counter view section on the topic. Sports should be optional in college. So your topic is sports should be optional in college, and they have given you certain points view section. Like at least, like, you know, it has heavy burden. Anyway, students are heavily burdened with studies. There is no time for sports. There are much important things to do, and academic success also is important. And there's lack of proper infrastructure. So these are all view sections. So you have to write counter view. So sports should be compulsory in colleges. Okay, so the topic is positive, but what you're writing is a negative to the view section which is given to you. So against, okay? So because view section is against the notion that sports should be compulsory, so in your counter view, you will be writing the opposite thing, that is, sports should be compulsory, okay? Then you have to give the necessary points in the way, in the format of paragraph, okay? So this is how you can write your view and counter view section writing skill in your paper. The next is report writing. Report writing. Now, what is a report? Report is a brief account of an event that has already taken place. Like something happened somewhere, some event has taken place somewhere, and you give a brief account of it. Okay, like what has happened, as if you have witnessed it. Okay, so it helps in recording the events. Like if nobody gives a report of a particular event, then how can we record? How we will come to know as to what happened in a particular on a particular day or in a particular place? So we will not know. So it helps us to record the events that happened in day-to-day life and attempts to present the first-hand information. When you write a report, you give a first-hand information of an incident or an event that has taken place. It can include your ideas, opinions, and impressions about the event, and it is written on account of something that one has observed. Okay, what you have observed, what you have heard, what you have done, what you have investigated, all those things you write in your report. So it is a systematic, well-organized presentation of facts and findings of an event which has already taken place somewhere. Again, report writing too has a format. That is, you will start with the headline. Okay, then there will be a byline, that is the name of the reporter. So headline, like, you know, in the newspaper, have you seen those bold headlines which are very catchy and they are short, but they are strong. Okay, so such kind of headlines you will give to your report. Then there will be a byline where you will specify your name. Okay, so it's a news article, if it's a news article or a magazine article. So you need to let the readers know who has written it. So in your newspaper, if you see, every article has the name of the reporter. So the line of your name is called a byline. Okay, because it tells us by whom the article is written. So the word byline. Then you have the opening paragraph, that is a lead paragraph. So in this paragraph, you have to answer these five main questions. Like, who was involved in the incident? What was the incident about? Where the incident took place? When the incident took place? And why the incident took place? So all the five WH questions you will answer in your opening paragraph. So the report usually begins with the name of the city where the report is being written and the date when it was written. Okay, so you have to remember that you have to write these things in your first paragraph. Day, date, time of the day when the incident happened. Names of the people or the events that took place, okay, the news is about. Then the place where it happened, okay, the details of the incident and reasons why they took place, okay, the incident. The next paragraph, that is next two paragraphs, should tell the reader how the incident happened in detail. Okay, like in the first one, you're just giving them a brief information that why, what, where, how, all things happened over there. Then in detail, you talk about the incident in the next two paragraphs. And then you have your concluding paragraph, which will include the action that has been taken. I suppose there is an accident that has taken place. So there's action that, you know, the local policemen have you know, hurriedly arrived and they have taken the patient to the hospital and proper care has been taken, you know, of the victims in the incident. So like that, depending on what kind of incident you are reporting, you will give the statement, the concluding statement. That is your last paragraph. Okay. Now, what are the points that you will remember? Mention the day, place, time, and other relevant facts about it. Then you can include information collected from, like, you can see a local policeman said, or a local shopkeeper nearby said, you know, these things about the event. So that you can include. You can, of course, you have to write the name of the reporter. You have to provide the suitable title. You have to write it in past tense because this incident has already happened. So it will be in past tense. Now, again, you can also use reported speech and use passive form of expression. Then you can develop ideas by saying the causes or the reasons why those things took place or why the consequences of those incidents. So those information also can be given, and less formal and more descriptive manner. So it has to describe the entire scenario to the reader. Okay. And while writing a report for a school magazine also, you can use the same way here, and you can present your ideas and impressions to make the report interesting. Okay. Like if you read the report in the newspaper and you read the report in the magazine, you will find that in the magazine, it is less formal. Okay, and more descriptive, while in the newspaper it is more formal, okay, which keeps to the facts, and that's all you can find over there. Okay, so here there's a sample report for you all for your reference. Okay, that is a super specialty hospital was inaugurated in your town by the health minister. As a reporter from the Hindu, write a brief report on the same. Okay, so they have given you the name of the hospital and the newspaper that you are coming from. So as I said, the title will be there, and then followed by who has written, okay, and then the place, the day where it took place, okay, and then you write in detail the information about that incident. Then here there is another one, okay, that is you had attended a workshop on personality development for students. Many eminent personalities had been present there. Write a report in 125 to 150 words on how the workshop proved to be beneficial to you. So you again give a title, okay, and your name and which class you're from, okay, and then you give the details of the entire event. And next writing skill is appeal writing. Okay, now what are appeals? You need to understand this very carefully. Appeals are used to create social awareness. Okay, when do you make an appeal? When you want to create a social awareness, awareness among the people around you. Okay, so these are done to involve people in general social activities. Either you want to make them aware about a social problem, or you want to encourage them in trying to solve the problems and to motivate them to take active part in the movement. So when you want to do these things, you write an appeal. Okay, when you want to make a major change in the society as such. Now, how do you make an appeal? You use catchy slogans, okay? You have to be really brief. You cannot go on writing paragraphs. Nobody has time to stand there and read the entire appeal, which is written in paragraphs. So you have to be very short and brief. Then you have to address directly to the reader. You have to tell you can make a difference. Like, you know, you can be the change, something like that. So, of course, the person will take it in his stride. Then seek reader's participation. See that the readers take participation in reading your appeal, and appeal to heart. Okay, you have to directly hit the nail when you write your appeal. Okay, so this is the appeal, sample appeal for blood donation. So see how you have, how it has been written. Okay, they have used some pictures and slogans, and you know, come forward, donate blood, so you can make a difference. So something like that. Okay, and so you make a box and then you write the appeal. Here you have catchy lines in the beginning, and then you write few things about the appeal that you're writing. Okay, another one can be, you know, this is one of the appeal which is in your textbook. Okay, Into the Wild, you have this lesson. So they have given you appeal writing, so there also you can go and check. But I have given you here, that is, you know, appeal writing here, which talks about the wildlife. So wildlife calling. So you know, you say that wildlife is mother nature's greatest treasure. Together we can and we should save it from becoming history. Like, otherwise we'll maybe do the awareness program to protect the wildlife. So that this is how you will write the appeal for this. If it is an incident or if you are having a program somewhere, okay, an awareness program or something like that, then you specify the time, date, where it is going to take place and all those in the appeal, okay. So this is the format for writing your appeal, okay. So here there is one more writing skill, that is to write a flyer. Now what is a flyer? A flyer is a small piece of paper, you know, which is given in a wide range, so wide distribution at a public place. So either you go to railway stations or you go to, you know, when you go for your examinations, exam centers, and outside those places, you will have these people standing and, you know, distributing flyers. So those are your flyers, which are given to individuals or sent through mail or post, and it is used for advertising. So maybe a classes has started somewhere, so they will stand outside your college, something like that. You must have experienced these things, okay? So there will be this flyer. So here you see there's a flyer which talks about admission in a particular college, okay, New Arts, Science and Commerce College. And then they give the details, the features, and why to, you know, choose this particular college. And then if you have any queries, they have given you contact details here. So this is how the format of the flyer should be as well. Just go through these writing skills, okay, which are in your textbook. And as I said, the writing skills, all of them are given. The topics are there in your textbook after the lesson. So please go to the respective lessons and choose one topic from the writing skills in that lesson and practice it. And I'm sure you will be able to write these writing skills well. Okay. So thank you and have a nice day.